Harrods it is, yeah?
Thank you very much.
For 350 years, the Black Cab has been a British institution.
Here you go, ladies.
Thank you. Safe and sound.
But with the rise of sat-navs and minicabs, including Uber, now outnumbering Black Cabs 4-1.
Kensington Thistle Hotel, please.
What is it that sets the cabbie apart from the rest?
London cab drivers are the best in the world. That's what the passenger is paying for, your knowledge, the ability to get them from A to B in the fastest possible route.
To join the cabbie's exclusive ranks, candidates must pass one of the hardest exams in the world, the knowledge of London.
Have a think about what you're doing.
Every year, 7,000 men and women take on the challenge.
It's probably like going to a boxing ring, but without the violence.
Taking an average of 4 years to pass this extraordinary test, only 30% survive to the end.
You have to eat, sleep and breathe the knowledge. This is not taking over your life, you're not doing it properly.
Every single one of the capital's 25,000 streets and 100,000 landmarks must be learned in a remarkable feat of memory, with candidates enduring multiple rounds of gruelling one-on-one exams.
You can see them physically sweating, huffing and puffing.
This is a day in the life of one of the most elite test centres in the world.
I don't think I could be any more scared or nervous than I already am.
Who has what it takes to earn the exclusive cabbie's badge?
Can I go back, sir, or I've got to finish?
Stone's throw from some of London's iconic landmarks is one of the most elite exam centres in the world.
Good morning.
How are you, all right?
Yeah, not too bad, thank you. Good weekend? Yeah, not bad.
It is just another office, but it's not if you're on the knowledge.
Today, like each weekday, more than 150 men and women pass through these doors determined to prove they have the knowledge to become a London black cabbie.
How are you feeling today?
It all depends on what you ask me.
Yeah.
Ask me 20 minutes time.
Yeah.
They will endure relentless rounds of nerve-jangling one-on-one oral tests, known as appearances. In four increasingly challenging stages, they'll memorise and be tested on every detail of London's intricate road system.
Doing the knowledge is probably one of the longest job interviews you'll ever have.
Mr. Advani.
Candidates will be rigorously tested by the examiners, active cabbies who were once star pupils themselves.
Most taxi drivers, they call us like the gatekeepers, but we're just there to uphold the standards so that we are the best in the world.
Hi, afternoon. All right. Different appearance.
Yes.
So how are you feeling?
Beyond nervous.
At school, I was more the disruptive one. Probably at that age now where I could actually tell my mum I did bunk off a lot. When the knowledge came along, it was completely new to me. It's like literally starting again.
33-year-old Everton is a bus driver from East London and father of four.
Go.
Go.
Everton started studying the knowledge of London 18 months ago, attracted by a cabbie's potential annual earnings of over £40,000.
I weren't bringing in enough money that I thought was enough that's going to bring them forward in life.
Now with his sights set on the cabbie's exclusive green badge, he is studying for at least 35 hours a week in the hope of achieving his dream job.
It's full time to juggle life and the knowledge. It has been hard. Getting that badge will change our life dramatically. The way we live will change, where we live will change. It's massive.
Test me on some runs.
Okay. Take me from Famous Three Kings to Theatre 503.
I think it's a good thing for my dad to do, but you don't get to see your dad as much. And I think when he passes, I'll get my dad back and we can be happy.
Dad?
Yeah?
I like it when you laugh when you do this.
How cheeky you are.
Family's everything, and I want to try and install a solid upbringing. I try and do everything I can to provide for the kids and my wife.
I managed to still do the school run this morning.
Oh, really?
Done a bit of work. But I didn't want to overdo it.
Yeah, I didn't want to overdo it this morning.
Yeah.
It's hard to find that healthy work and knowledge balance, ain't it?
But I'm telling you, man. He scares me.
You heard him yet?
No. But I've heard.
Hi.
Good luck, mate. Cheers.
Everton is on stage one, the first of four sets of multiple exams. If he accrues enough points today, he can move on to stage two.
I've been a nightclub promoter, I've been a photographer, you name it, I've probably doubled my hands in it. That was my way of life before the knowledge. It's probably the only thing that I've kind of stuck to. There's people depending on me.
Mr. Thomas.
Afternoon, ma'am.
Okay, good afternoon, sir. You got your scorecard?
Yes, ma'am.
Take a seat.
Thank you, ma'am.
You make your own luck on the knowledge. If you put the work in, then it will pay off.
All right, so you've not seen me before, Mr. Thomas. My name is Ms. Channels. Okay.
Nice to meet you.
Ready to start?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's give it a go. Right, question one. Whereabouts is Kensington Village?
Kensington Village.
So not only have you got to do the knowledge and learn London and learn all the points, you've also got to hold it together and try and keep calm.
Sorry, Mum, I'm not seeing that.
No, you sure? OK. We're going to go from the London Edition Hotel.
Everton needs to pinpoint two locations out of London's 100,000 landmarks.
Yes, Berners Street, Mum.
It is, yeah. I'd like to go from there to Battersea Reach.
Battersea Reach, oh, Juniper Drive, Mum.
That's it, yeah. So London Edition Hotel to Battersea Reach.
He must recite the most direct route, naming every road correctly, without hesitation.
OK, Mum. OK, if I leave on the right Berners Street, left into East Castle Street, left Wells Street, forward Berwick Street, right into Knoll Street, forward Great Marlborough Street, left into Regent Street.
You could just go wrong, just like that. You could just do an illegal turn and your appearance is gone.
Forward into Westbridge Road, forward into Battersea Square, forward Vicarage Crescent, forward into Lombard Road, right into York Road, forward and comply York Circus, lead by York Road, left into Juniper Drive, Mum.
OK, and I'm brave.
Thank you. Wow.
Okie dokie. All right, we started off a little bit wobbly, but we brought it back, so well done, Sam.
Thank you, Mum. Yeah?
After 18 months of arduous study and sacrifice, Everton has made it onto stage two.
Hi, how'd you get on?
Yeah, good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's what I like to hear.
Just to hear the examiner say, well done. Do you know what I mean? It's just another stage. Another stage is another hurdle. Every hurdle is just getting closer and closer. I've scored today. It's Chinese tonight.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Cheers. Have a good day. Cheers.
We've got 70% dropout rate on the knowledge. No one ever fails it, they just give up. If you can break through the first few appearances, chances are you can finish it.
Mr. Brown, please.
Mr. Everson, please.
First appearance is horrible because it's fear of the unknown.
You try and relax with me as much as you can, all right?
You could cut the tension with a knife.
Good morning, here for an appearance.
Yes, my first appearance today, Nikki Lynch.
Miss Lynch, yep, no problem at all. Can I just get you to sign in, please?
Yeah.
How are you feeling today?
Nervous?
Yeah. You'll be okay.
I've been studying for 2.5 years. I have worked really hard on the lead up to this.
Today is 32-year-old firefighter Nikki's first ever visit to the test centre.
I believe that in life you should always try your hardest at everything and never give up.
With dreams of buying her own home, Nikki hopes to increase her income by also working shifts as a black cab driver.
Lynch, please, Lynch. Hi, Mum.
Hello, sir.
Please take a seat.
Thank you.
Okay. Hello there, good morning.
Hello, sir.
Right, first appearance.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You're nice and calm, aren't you?
No, my heart is in my mouth.
Right, calm down, then you'll be okay. Where's Central Square? Central Square.
Central Square is Heathgate, sir.
It is. We're going to go to the Trellick Tower. Where's the Trellick Tower?
Trellick Tower is Goldbourne Road, sir.
It is.
Once we start the appearances, you can actually feel the fear.
I can't see anything. I'm sorry, sir, I just can't see nothing now.
See at all.
I just think nerves probably took over and I just clammed up, I suppose. I'm sorry.
No need to apologise. Just concentrate on the next one. All right, that one's gone. That one's finished.
Okay,
Sutton House. Where's Sutton House? Sutton House Museum.
Sutton House Museum is on Homerty High Street.
Okay, and from there we're going to go to the Baltic Exchange.
Baltic Exchange is Leadenhall Street. St Mary's Axe, sorry. St Mary's Axe.
Yep. As I say, it's no rush. Go when you're ready.
Okay. So, leave on the left Homerton High Street, left Morning Lane. Leave on the left Homerton High Street, left Ponsford Street, right Morning Lane, left Vallette Street. From what everyone used to say to me about, oh, it's horrible, it's like your worst nightmare in the chair. Like, now I can really understand what they mean. It really does feel horrible in that chair. I've completely lost where I'm going now. May I go back to... I just panicked. I felt like I couldn't breathe and my heart was in my throat. So if I just go left carriage...
Just calm down. Take a few breaths. Just calm down.
Right Whitechapel Road, forward Whitechapel High Street, forward Aldgate High Street, forward Aldgate, bear right Leadenhall Street, right St Mary's Axe, and then I'd sit down on the right, sir.
Okay, you can do that. Okay, right. You're not scored today.
No.
A lot of pressure on you today.
Nikki has failed to earn enough points to pass. She will need to resit this exam on her next visit to the test centre.
Thank you very much.
All right. Good lesson learned today. Don't panic.
I know, I was panicking.
Sometimes they do get upset and it's very difficult, but you've got to try and keep to the job we're doing.
It's not going to stop me from working hard and trying hard at the next one.
When I see people for a first appearance, they say, oh, Mum, please tell me the nerves are going to get better towards the end. And you can't lie to them because you know that in actual fact, it gets worse.
How'd you go?
Too much pressure.
Oh.
Sometimes I politely nod and go, yeah, you'll get used to it. It's fine, don't worry. But in the back of my head, I'm thinking, oh, I don't envy you one bit.
For the past 150 years, the only route to becoming a black cab driver was passing the Knowledge of London. Little has changed in the test since 1865, and it is still recognised as the hardest exam of its kind.
Everyone knows that the black cab trade is the best in the world.
700 hopeful cabbies sign up to the challenge every year.
Mr. O'Connell, please.
On a day like today, over 100 will be called in front of the examiners to prove their knowledge.
There is a lot of pride in having the knowledge.
Forward Cheltenham Road, right Kelvington Road, on our crematorium on the right.
Well done. Yeah. I like the use of some of the roads that you're using. Cheltenham, Kelvington, things like that. Some of the stuff that you're calling is really on point.
That's what the passenger is paying for, your knowledge, the ability to get them from A to B in the fastest possible route.
Prince Edward Fair?
Yes.
Thank you.
But cabbies are under increasing pressure to be better than the rest, with unprecedented competition from sat-navs, minicab services, and the likes of Uber.
Passenger puts his arm up, gets in the taxi and says, well, I want to go to the stage door, Waterloo Station. There's no sat-nav in the world that's going to tell you where that is.
Students must commit to memory London's 2,000 miles of roads and ever-changing hotels, shops and restaurants. And the best way to do this is on a scooter.
I bought my bike brand spanking new. When I finished the knowledge, the bike blew up.
Sun
rain, snow, sleet, you're out on your bike. I've got my thermals on. I've even got my daughter's hot water bottle just underneath my lap there.
If I had got paid for being on that bike, I'd be a rich man. Yeah, it's lonely. I've been out there. I've been sitting on the bike, cold, wet. I remember warming my gloves on the exhaust and they melted. And then I had no gloves to go home with, so I'd take my socks off and use them to drive home.
There are four stages to the knowledge, and today many candidates are sitting stages 2 and 3.
Morning.
Morning, sir. You OK?
Yeah.
Yeah, not too bad. Got you. You feeling confident today?
No.
My dad's 90 in a few weeks' time, and I'm 60, and he retired, I think, at 58, 59, as a teacher. And I'm thinking, oh, he retired. I'm just about to launch on a new career.
You'd just like to go through to our waiting room there.
You've got Mr. Hewitt.
He's all right. Finding for his first appearance.
How old is Mr. Hewitt, Paul?
1956, so he's...
He's 60.
Yeah, 60. Good plot, Tom.
It's good, good though, isn't it? Someone like that.
He's just got to take his time and he's all right and he'll be OK.
We've got 7 children, ranging from the age of 34 down to 13, and we've got 11 grandchildren.
Is it like a school exam?
No, nothing like a school exam at all. It's very intimidating.
The knowledge came out of a necessity to, you know, think about another job, really, and what can I do at this age? It's the next part of our life.
60-year-old Mike is hoping that the flexible hours as a cabbie and being your own boss will see him nicely into retirement.
Hello.
But he's already spent 4.5 years studying and is only just beginning stage 3.
Mike's memory, well, oh my goodness, he can't even remember his kids' names sometimes, can you?
No.
No.
The sheer volume, complexity and detail of information that Mike must learn is comparable to that required to earn a degree in law or medicine.
I'm really proud of him. You know, his stickability, his determination, and he's doing it for us, you know, for our older age and for our family.
Hewitt, please. Hewitt. Sir, got your card there? Lovely. Can I sit down, sir? I've got the door. Just worry about sitting down. Lovely. OK, sir, I've seen you a couple of times now. I'm still Mr. Whitehead. You're still Mr. Hewitt. Good. Royal Society of Watercolours, please. Where's the Royal Society of Watercolours?
Hopton Street.
OK, and from there we're going to go to Putney Library, please.
That's Disraeli Road.
Thank you.
It feels like the workings of your brain are being examined.
Right, Sumner Street, right... Southwark Street.
You know you're going to be fearful, but you just know you've just got to get through it. You just, not to be afraid of fear, actually is a good thing to learn, I think.
Good afternoon, how are you doing?
Thank you.
How are you feeling?
Nervous as always, but a bit more in control this time.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's a good sign.
Lovely, good luck. Thanks a lot.
Do you want to take a glass of water? Before you help yourself?
It's been a long, long road for me. I've had lots of lows, more lows, I've had highs, suffered bad from nerves, which is a shame for me because I'm the one that's held myself back because of my nerves.
Single mum Jo has been studying the knowledge for 6.5 years.
I try not to look at other people and I just try and compose myself and breathe. Some people just suffer from nerves. I've always been a people's person and I love driving. First left is Portsmouth Street. I did used to do the knowledge on a motorbike and I did it for about a year. I used to drive down from Essex to London on the A12 and I swear my butt cheeks would be so clenched and I would be sweating because I was terrified. And then one day I came off on black ice and I broke my wrist and thumb. Tried to get back onto the bike afterwards and I cried all the way down my little road here to a roundabout doing 5 miles per hour and I just thought, I can't do it. What would I be like going around Marble Arch, Piccadilly? So I got the smart car. All right, boys, be with you soon. I can't wait to get out of here. We have so much fun. you don't know who you're going to get, so you don't know who's going to come and call you, you don't know what door is going to open, so you're like this all the time.
Today, Joe will be examined by Mr. Gunning.
Mr. Gunning, nice man. Pass.
He's a good examiner. He's tough, but he's good. He knows his stuff. So the vast majority would sit on that sofa hoping that he didn't call their name in.
Miss Chandler, please.
I think I have got a bit of a reputation. Okay. I'm known as a difficult examiner, to be honest with you.
All right. Try and relax. See how you get on today, okay?
Okay,
sir. All right, good. Where's the Barcelona Tapas restaurant? SE22.
You feel extremely exposed. You know, it's almost like someone's got a spotlight on you.
Brain's gone blank. Just keep moving.
Feeling that embarrassing drip of a sweat going down your spine. That's when I feel like my anxiety kicks in.
Mr. Mordrick, please.
Mr. Cope.
The knowledge appearance is probably like going to a boxing ring, you know, but without the violence. It's like walking out in front of like 40,000 people, but there's only one person sitting in front of you.
To prepare for today, candidates halfway through the process will have already put in 4,000 hours of study.
The Token House Bar. Where's the Token House?
Oh, Token House. Moorgate.
OK. West Hampstead Library.
West Hampstead. Dennington Park Road. Or corner of.
Corner. OK, of, yep.
That's West End.
Lovely. Token House Bar to West Hampstead Library. Thank you, sir.
Mike needs to earn 6 points out of a possible 10 on this final question. If he fails to call a direct route or misses out a section, he won't score today.
I'm going to leave on the left Moorgate, right Lothbury.
Your brain works on nervous energy that then suddenly blanks out everything else.
Forward into, Fleet Road, left into Pond Street, forward into Lyndhurst Road, forward into Lymington Road, left into West End Lane, set down on the right.
Okay, sir. Not scored today.
No, and there's some bad lines.
You did miss out quite a bit.
Oh, did I?
Yeah.
I did the best I could, to be honest. You know, I know my limitations. I have got a terrible memory and always have asked my wife.
OK, thank you very much.
Bye-bye,
have a good
sir.
Day, won't you? Thank
sir.
You. See you later.
Oh, my goodness. There must be an end to this. He better get his badge. After
I'll
all this.
Get my badge.
Yeah, but you will get your badge.
Thanks very much. OK, have a good day. See you later.
So I'm really sorry, but I can't remember my first point. Sorry.
It's the Boltons. And run me down to the Mahatma Gandhi Trading Estate, or Industrial Estate, as it's now called.
Milkwood Road, sir.
Good.
I've never suffered from nerves or anxiety before in my whole life, but I don't back out of something.
I'm going to leave this by Tregunta Road. I'm going to do a left onto Earls Court Road, left into Old Brompton Road. I'm going to do a right into Cranley Mews, right Cranley Gardens, left onto Fulham Road.
All right. Just hold just for one moment. Listen to me carefully. You think about what you're doing. Think about how you're leaving this point. Make sure I'm going to give you another go at this, OK?
I just closed down. It was fighting so hard for them shutters not to come down. No, come on, don't let it happen. Forward into Hernhill Junction, leave by right Milkwood Road, it's on the left, sir.
OK. All right, I can't score you today, I'm afraid. I really can't.
Okay.
Absolutely devastated.
The knowledge just doesn't teach you about London, it also teaches you about yourself.
I'm not going to give up, I'm just going to keep on going.
It's nerve-wracking stuff.
How much are you actually able to push yourself? Are you prepared to take a few knocks along the way in order to achieve your goal?
Competition in the capital's taxi trade is at a record high. 1,800 new minicab drivers, including Uber, sign up every month, compared to only 110 new black cab drivers that qualify each month to join this elite club.
It's not just a taxi driver. You're a gentleman of the city. You'll go to a cab driver if you're in trouble. They'll take you to hospital.
It's like London without a bus or London without Buckingham Palace.
Anyone can apply to become a cabbie. And for many of today's candidates, it's a fresh start.
Sometimes your candidates come through that in their life that they have struggled. It completely changes some people's lives.
Afternoon, is that Mr. Salito?
Yes,
Mr. Hi. Salito. How are you keeping today?
Not bad.
I don't think there is any cab in the world that looks more beautiful than the black cab.
At just 14 years old, Saimir fled Kosovo to build a new life for himself in England.
I left Kosovo because I wasn't very happy there, so I just wanted opportunities and be more happy.
35-year-old Saimir has been studying the knowledge for 4 years and is on the penultimate stage.
Over the years, oh, I had a lot of jobs. I was a builder. I worked for a year or two, and then I became a bus driver. And then after that, I decided to do the knowledge. I wanted to do the knowledge for a long time.
Saimir spends 45 hours a week studying for his dream job, driving one of the country's iconic black cabs.
When you work hard for things, you become more proud. I know this knowledge made me a better person. I've done it for myself.
Each stage, the questions get harder and the journey's more obscure. To ensure he scores today, Saimir must prove he's learned every single one of London's cut-throughs in its vast network of 25,000 streets.
Mr. Salita?
You're scared. It's just a fear of failing, you know? That pressure we put on ourselves.
All right, question one. Let's go from the Royal British Society of Sculptors.
That is on Old Brompton Road?
Correct, yeah. That's it. And I'd like to go to the Royal Institute of British Architects.
That's on to Portland Place.
Correct, so have a little think, go when you're ready. Royal British Society of Sculptors to the Royal Institute of British Architects.
Okay, ma'am.
For myself, I think the more you use your brain, it's the better, because you're training your brain. It's like the muscles of your body, or God gave us brain so we can use it.
Recent memory studies show that between the years 2000 and 2015, our attention span fell to just 8 seconds.
We sometimes look at the goldfish as having quite a low attention span. It seems that humans have dropped below that level now. I think we're all becoming increasingly digitalized, and I think that's having quite a negative effect on our memories.
Jonathan Hancock is a former world memory champion, and since the age of 16, holds the Guinness Book of Records for memorizing packs of playing cards.
I've worked with people of all ages in lots of different walks of life. I haven't yet worked with London taxi drivers. There are few, if any, other professions where you've got to remember quite so much information.
Jonathan is running a study and wants to explore how cab drivers are able to remember London's complex network of roads and 100,000 landmarks, comparing their memory ability and techniques to a control group of non-cab drivers. The tests are designed to play on different strengths, including speed and multitasking. The final test looks at how well people learn from a list.
Tin tomatoes.
My head was spinning with the list.
And compares that to memory mapping.
That's the pattern that we want you to try and remember. So 45 seconds to try to get that picture in your head, then we'll take the object away and you'll try to put them back in the right places. Good luck starting now. I'm interested to know if they are still able to learn things when they're written down, or if they're just naturally better at learning when things are laid out and they can map them in front of them and see them and use the visual.
I would learn sequences of roads by having sort of silly sentences. Yeah. The paintbrush needed to be down there because the giraffe was doing some painting.
Yeah, that's it. That was definitely it.
Well done. It looked like you found that easier than when it was just a list.
That's all that scooter work, man.
Yeah.
I think if you're used to learning from paper, from screens, you're likely to find that easier. You're likely to have techniques for doing it. If you're used to, say, being out in the real world or looking at images a lot more, that's likely to be your comfort zone as well.
You seem quite confident with the way you started over there, and then you knew that those were in the middle.
This group of London taxi drivers was faster at tackling these tests. Their speed of memory and recall, but also their ability to multitask. These cabbies are using ways of thinking in pictures and telling stories and using mental routes. For thousands of years, actually, people have been using that ability. The ancient Greeks tapped into it, the Romans tapped into it with their learning techniques.
Well done. You're really fast and really confident with lots of those.
Yep.
I think the black cabbies are a really good example of almost sort of standing up against technology. The idea of neuroplasticity, the idea that we're changing our brains by the ways we use them, I think that's a really positive thing. I think these taxi drivers are quite inspirational because they're proving how powerful the human brain is.
One second. Just want to stay low.
Keep it calm, okay? Great.
Yes. It makes you look life different because hard things make you a strong person. That's how I see it. Every time you go there, you get stronger. Right onto Weymouth Street, left onto Upper Wimpole Street, right Devonshire Street, right Portland Place, down on left.
Okay, well done, Mr. Salita.
I'm feeling very good. I scored today. It went perfect. It can't be better. It's hard. It's not easy. Otherwise, everyone would have done it.
Hi, how'd you get on? Still
scored.
Smiling?
Scored, mate.
There you go.
Yeah. Definitely, the knowledge opens doors for people and it gives people a second chance. Yeah.
Two more successful appearances and Saimir will earn his green badge.
Now a couple more appearances.
And that's it, yeah.
There you go.
I think next year I'll be a cab driver.
Thank you, sir. I'll see you guys in 3 days, 2 weeks.
Candidates taking their final exams will have committed an average of 8,000 hours in the hope of achieving their badge.
Heathrow Terminal 4 to Wembley Central Station, please.
For most, life has been put on hold to pursue the cabbie's £37,000 average salary and the chance to be your own boss.
Mr. Tolfrey?
Yeah.
Oh, you're here for your final appearance.
I lost my job probably 5 years ago, which I didn't quite see coming.
43-year-old father of two, Paul, has worked in the city all his life. 4.5 years ago, he made the decision to change career.
Losing my job gave me the kick up the backside I needed, because at the end of the day, I've got to provide my family and myself. I've got to keep a roof over our heads.
He's on the very last stage of the knowledge. If he passes today, he will finally join the exclusive club of black cab drivers. Today, he will be tested on London's 22 suburbs.
It's been an incredible amount of sacrifices, not only from me, but from my family as well.
Finals. Sweet, yeah? That's all right, isn't it?
There ain't been a thing on this I found easy. It's been an absolute chore. I'm still crippled by the nerves, though, mate.
What?
I'm still crippled by the nerves, mate. It does, mate.
Yeah,
good.
Carried one out the other week.
Carried one out?
Got one out.
Blimey. Yeah. Yeah, it's not good. Been very, very dejected once or twice when I've not scored. Don't think I could have committed even more to the knowledge than I already have, but you don't know if it's going to be your day or not.
Toll free, please. Yes. Toll free. Morning, sir. Did you bring your card with you today?
Did, sir, yeah.
Lovely, thank you. Have I sit down? Okay, sir. Nice to see you again. I'm still Mr. Whitehead. You're still Mr. Telfer, yeah?
I am, yes.
Good. Okay. finals today. Good answer. Heathrow Terminal 4 to Wembley Central Station, please.
Just leave on the left Salisbury Road, apply Terminal 4 roundabout, leave by Swansea Road, and it's forward Great South West Road. Struggling with the next road, I've got this. It is the thought of who you're doing this for, what your motivations for doing this in the first place that kind of get you through. Left Uxbridge Road, right back into Uxbridge Road, left Greenford Road, apply Greenford roundabout, lead by Western Avenue, bare left first slip. Left Argyle Road, right Tynemouth Gardens, left Biddeford Avenue, forward Aintree Road, right Bilton Road, apply roundabout, right Bilton Road, forward Manor Farm Road, apply roundabout, leave by Bridgewater Road, right Ealing Road, left into Wembley High Road, just sit down on the right.
Okay. Do you know what that run was? So that was your last run you done on the London Knowledge, sir. Well done, you passed.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thanks.
Well done, sir. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Oh. Oh, my God. Oh.
I've got butterflies at the moment. I've just... can't take it in, actually. It's, what a feeling. Just phenomenal feeling. I feel like shouting it out from the rooftops now that I've done it. I've done it. Done, mate.
The knowledge is hard, isn't it? There's no two ways about that. There's no shortcuts. You have got to have done the knowledge to join the club of a London taxi driver, and you do feel a lot of pride in that.
Done.
Yeah?
Passed? Yeah.
Well done. Thank you very much.
All of a sudden, I've got my life back, my wife's got a husband back, and my children have got their dad back. It's really difficult to put in words.
Yeah, brilliant. Thank you.
I take care.
I feel about 10 feet tall.
Forward Sussex Gardens, left Bennett Street, right Arlington Street.
Comply airport roundabout, leave by each room. Comply.
You have to eat, sleep and breathe the knowledge. If it's not taking over your life, you're not doing it properly.
A staggering 70% of those who take on the knowledge of London will never make it to the final stage at the test centre.
There is a high dropout rate, and it's the reason for it is simply people just don't quite actually realise how much dedication it takes.
The knowledge is a marathon, it's not a sprint. It's a real character test, you know, it shows real resilience.
It's a full-time job trying to learn the knowledge and to learn it effectively.
It's a new day at the test centre, and 27 candidates are sitting their final exam.
I do love the knowledge, and I love what the knowledge has done to me, and I love the way the knowledge has made me who I am.
39-year-old Dan has been a black cab mechanic for the past 20 years.
I've been feeling all right, right up until yesterday.
I'm all right. I felt a bit ill this morning. Thing is, I don't think I could be any more scared or nervous than I already am, you know what I mean? There's something seriously wrong here. Look at this.
It's alive.
Look. I grew up in a council estate in the middle of Clapham. And it was pretty rough. It had one of the most notorious gangs on it. And I grew up sort of under them. Academically at school, I weren't no good at all. I couldn't read properly, can't write, couldn't spell nothing. I had a bit of a rough time. I jumped around from school to school for fighting. I was always in some sort of pickle or another.
Dan lives in South London with his wife and two kids. 4 years ago, he decided that rather than just fix people's cabs, he wanted to drive one of his own.
That's my cup, nearly. First, I doubted myself. I thought, oh, I'm never going to be able to do that. And after a period of time, it just started flowing, it just started working. And I started recognising words a bit quicker, a bit easier. You have to put your heart and soul into being what you want to be the most, you know, in anything you do.
Can I put that there?
Yeah. Ah!
It all comes down to today. If he scores, he will finally become a fully-fledged cabbie after 4 years of studying.
Throughout my life, people have always knocked me or put me down. I've actually been told that by several school teachers when I was at school. You'll never make nothing of your life.
Mr. O'Connell, please.
To achieve getting my badge means the world to me. It means everything.
You've got your card, sir. Lovely. Yes, don't leave when you go. Right, sir, see you a couple of times now. You here for your finals?
Yes, sir. I'd love to be able to be my own boss and just control my destiny. And that's what the knowledge gives you. I could play it roundabout, leave by Bridgewater Road, left Ealing Road, right High Road, Wembley, set down on my right, sir.
OK, lovely. Still breathing?
Just about.
All right, have you got a drop of water there?
I have, yeah.
Have a mouthful.
Every time, sir, every time. You can do whatever your mind tells you you can do. You know, if you say that you can't do it, you can't do it. And you got to believe you can and you got to want to.
Just going to ask you the 2 points and you run them. Right, so Lewisham High Street to Sidcup Station.
Lewisham High Street to get to Sidcup Station. Leave Lewisham High Street by Lee Bridge, Ford Lee High Road, Ford Lee Green, Ford Elton Road, right Sidcup Road, Kaplan Clifford's roundabout, leave by Sidcup Road, left into County Gate, right into Footscray Road, forward into Main Street, left into Longlands Road, forward into Heavily Crescent, forward into Faraday Avenue, left into Jubilee Way, set my right.
Lovely. Do you know what that last one was?
The last one?
Yeah. Significance of that last one?
No, sir, I don't.
It's the last one you're going to do in the London Knowledge. Well done, sir.
Thank you very much, Mr. Wade.
Well done, congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Great achievement, sir. Well done.
Thank you very much, sir. You did say you were going to give me my badge. My family are going to be so proud of me.
Good. It's a big achievement. It's a journey, sir. You've been on a journey. It's not easy. It's not easy. The knowledge is not easy.
I know, sir. I know.
Oh. But it can be done.
It can be.
You apply yourself and it can be done.
I have done. I have done, sir. I've put every heart and soul, tears, grit, grime, everything you could imagine into it. You know, I just looked at my kids and thought, right, this has got to be done.
That's right.
So that means I'm a cab driver.
Yes, sir. You're done with the knowledge.
Thank you ever so much, sir. Much appreciated.
No problem whatsoever.
Thank you, sir. Oh. I don't think I've ever felt like this before in my life. When my daughter was born, my son was born, that was it. So I feel like I'm floating.
Well, you've done this, this is all about you. Is this what you've done?
I don't think I'm going to stop smiling for a month.
You know, it makes me feel warm inside, you know, to actually achieve something of such stature.
Great. Good luck, son. I'll see you out there.
Hopefully I'll see you in the road one day.
Yeah, mate. I'll see you out there. Listen, he's up. Nice one. Good luck today, boys. All right? Well done. Yes, my son!
As soon as you give someone the badge, their life will change. And for me, that's what my job is all about. It just makes my day.
For a split second, you remember when you finished, and it's really nice being part of someone's journey.
Mr. O'Connell! Mr. O'Connell!
Thank you very much, I much appreciate it.
It's a whole emotional rollercoaster, really, yeah, isn't it? But I'm proud of you for doing it.
Getting that badge will be massive.
When I put it on my neck, and I'll be the happiest person in life.
You know, I'm going to wear it like it's a Chanel necklace or something. You know, I'm going to wear it with pride.
After 31 gruelling appearances, is 43-year-old father of two Paul's first day on the job.
It's a culmination of 4 years hard studying that finally I'm in a position where I can pick passengers up and drive them around and earn money from it as well. Big moment, we can do this.
Hi, how you doing?
To Harrods.
Harrods? Yeah, no problem. Right, Harrods it is, yeah?
Thank you.
Cool.
It's been a long journey. I've been knocked down a few times and I've had to dust myself off. But it's been well worth it, just for this feeling at the end.
Here we go.
Perfect, thank you.
Okay.
As it's my first day in the job,
tradition dictates that we give a job away. So this one's not going to cost you today.
Oh, that's really kind of you. Thank you very much.
That's all right, my pleasure.
Well, I hope you do well. Thank you very much indeed.
Okay. All right, you take care of yourselves.
London for me is just, I love it. You know, I've been born and bred here. I've lived South London all my life. A lot of people go, oh, drivers don't go South London. Well, this driver will go South London.
Do you take cards?
I do take cards. All right, Smith Square, no problem. The knowledge changes people's lives, and it's changed mine. Yeah, that's the way I feel about it. I think it'd be here for a long, long time.
Sorry,
Doc. No worries. Here you go, ladies.
Thank
I'm safe
you.
And sound.
Everything from the STD clinic to A&E, they are the future, but what are the confessions of a junior doctor next Wednesday at 9? Coming up, online dating. What could possibly go wrong? Sexual deception with wildly different motives is what? A new series, My Online Nightmare.